Do you ever feel like you're struggling to keep track of your family's schedule? Today I'm going to show you how to build a simple, smart family planner using a Raspberry Pi 5, a touch display, and a 3D printed stand. It's got a calendar, weather updates, and even plays back photos that all sync from your family members' phones, all powered by free software. There are some commercial versions of these family planners available, but they're quite expensive, and on top of that, they often hide important features like photo playback behind monthly subscriptions. So there's ongoing costs to consider too. So let's get started building our own. As the brains behind the planner, I'm going to be using a Raspberry Pi 5. This is a little overkill for this project, but I intend using the same device for a separate Home Assistant dashboard and some other tasks running in the background, so I'd like to have the extra power available. If you're just using the planner functionality, then a Pi 3 or 4 or even a Pi 02W will work too. Next, we need a display. And for that I'm going with this 10.1-inch touch display from Sunfounder. This is a 1280x800 IPS display with a 178-degree viewing angle, so it's a good fit for this type of project. This particular model is nice and easy to use, because it's designed specifically for the Pi 5, so it includes all of the necessary cables to connect the Pi to the display, and it caters for the Pi 5's 5V 5A power supply requirements, so you don't need to run separate power supplies. It even includes speakers, so you can make use of audio prompts or voice feedback if you'd like to. Because the display package includes the power supply and all of the cables we need, the only other item we need is a microSD card for the operating system. I'm using a 32GB SanDisk Ultra card, which is more than enough for this project. I've flashed Raspberry Pi OS onto the microSD card, and I've configured it to connect to my home Wi-Fi network, so we can put that straight into the Pi and then get the Pi mounted onto the back of the display. This is done using little standoffs on adjustable rails, so you can mount any SBC with a square bolt pattern onto it. The Pi is secured by three M2.5x18mm brass standoffs, and a clear acrylic cover plate goes over it. I've also added a small stick-on heatsink. I'm not sure if this is going to provide enough cooling to the Pi yet, but it's easy to replace if I need to, and the acrylic cover has a place to mount a 40mm fan as well. We can then plug in the HDMI cable, the power cable, and the USB cable for the touch display. The board on the back of the display has buttons to control the display menu and speaker volume, and a power button to turn off the display and power to the Pi. And that's the hardware basically done. Sunfounder have a 3D printable stand and an enclosure available for this display, but the stand doesn't suit my needs, and I think the enclosure makes the display look quite bulky. So I decided to rather design my own stand for it, with an adjustable arm to position it exactly where I want it. The stand can also be hung from the underside of a surface like an overhead kitchen cabinet, which is the way I'll be using it long term. I printed the components out in black and grey PETG. I used PETG rather than PLA to provide better long term strength. The stand goes together really easily, with just three M6x50mm bolts holding the joints together. These can be adjusted and tightened using the 3D printed end caps. It would actually be best to use two 40mm bolts and one 50mm bolt, but rather than have to buy two sets, I'll cut the longer ones down or put caps on them afterwards. The stand attaches to some brass standoffs on the back of the display with four M2.5x12mm button head screws. Now let's get it booted up and set up the software. The two software options that I like are Dakboard and Magic Mirror. Dakboard is much easier to get set up and running, but is a bit more limited than Magic Mirror. Magic Mirror is open source, free, and has a large online community behind it, so it's got hundreds of available modules and a lot of flexibility, although this does mean that it takes much longer to get installed, set up, and running. Dakboard is great if you want a simple calendar interface with a few basic add-ons. The base features are free to use, which include up to two calendar integrations, a choice of predefined layouts, an integration with photos, weather, and a newsfeed. Additional calendars, custom layouts, and more integrations are available through two paid tiers, and while these aren't particularly expensive, they defeat the object of building your own device. So if you feel like the free version of Dakboard isn't enough for you, then I'd encourage you to try out Magic Mirror as an alternative. I'm going to use the free tier of Dakboard, as I primarily want to have a shared family calendar available to view. To get set up, create an account, and you can then work through setting up your predefined screen by running through these tabs. First, we need to choose a layout. I like the calendar on the left and the weather on the right. Then choose a background. There are options for integration with Apple Photos, Google Photos, OneDrive, Dropbox, and a host of other services too. You can even set a YouTube video as the background if you'd like to. I'm using a shared Apple photo album, which is set up on my family members' phones. Shared albums are quite easy to make. You just go to the Photos app on your device, scroll down to Shared Albums, then hit Create. Give it a name and invite participants that can contribute photos to the album. To make it accessible through Dakboard, you need to go to Shared Album Details, then make sure that Public Website is enabled, and then press Share Link to get a link which you can then copy over to Dakboard. We've then got some calendar display settings which affect the way your calendar shows up. I'll show you both the monthly and agenda views, but I like the standard monthly view and the agenda view across 7 days. I also like including the event location and end times as well. With the free tier, you can connect up to 2 calendars. You only really need one, as we run a shared iCloud calendar across our family phones, and we can add, change, or remove events from any device. There are some similar options available with Google Calendar. Setting this up is also quite easy to do. First, you need a calendar to link. You can use an existing calendar or create a new shared calendar with other family members. Once you've created a calendar, click on the eye alongside it to edit it. In this menu, you can enable it as a public calendar and then get a share link like we did with the photo album. We then copy this URL across to Dakboard. I added a second calendar link to Google Calendar showing the Australian public holidays too, just as an illustration. That's the basic setup done. You can also add the date and time, weather, news, a to-do list, and some custom text. To view the screen, we then click this link at the top. Try playing around with different settings to customize the screen to your needs. Once you've got it set up the way you like, we can link our Raspberry Pi to our account. Go to Displays and Devices and then create a new display. I've called mine Kitchen. Then go to this web address in the Pi's browser to link it. Rather than have to open up the browser and the link each time the Pi boots up, we can set it to do this automatically. First, we need to create an auto start directory. We then create a new text file in this location with these lines. The third line opens up Chromium in kiosk or full screen mode, and it then goes to your calendar dashboard. You'll need to copy the URL across from your Dakboard account for this linked device, so that it goes to the correct dashboard automatically. Let's reboot the Pi and see if it works. So now we've got a family planner running on the Pi, displaying our shared family calendar, and it cycles through the photos from a shared album on our phones. The last thing you might want to do is set the Pi to shut down at night to save power and increase the lifespan of the display. You can do this by adding a shutdown line in crontab, which will turn off the Pi every night at a set time. The Pi doesn't have an easy way to wake it up again, but I've got around this by having it on a smart plug. The plug turns off 10 minutes after the Pi shuts down, and then turns on again in the morning, which in turn boots the Pi back up again. Let me know what you think of this project in the comment section below, and let me know if you've tried Magic Mirror or any other software packages that you'd recommend for a home planner. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.